So I went about putting another band together. But this band had a different understanding of the music. It was like a younger approach, more commercial approach.
Started with Donald Whitehead, Wade Fleming, Sherry Scott, and I was only 19, so I was like the baby in the band. So I was just sort of like kind of hanging on, you know, just learning, you know, learning how to hear all this big music. I started playing upright bass when I was 15. And then Louis Satterfield, who was a bass guitar maestro, just like James Jamison in Detroit, was my bass guitar teacher. So I had like the classical, technical, foo-foo stuff during the day. And at night I'd play those funky clubs. And then on weekends I'd go to Sat's house. I'd have to say everything I know on bass guitar, Louis Satterfield taught me.
He was very sincere. He always did exactly what I told him. He's a very fine bassist. He's a rhythm king. And I know one because I'm one.
I came out to Los Angeles and I put Earth, Wind & Fire together.
And I was staying at the Landmark and I invited him to come out and join the band.
Of course, I leaped at the chance, you know, because I had never been anywhere. I had never traveled. I had never been away from home. So it was a big thing for me. It really, when I look back at it, it was not only musical change, it was a life change.
I was telling him about Jim Brown when we came to the house.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, man, and I used to like be so up, you know, I still am. I was like, and Reese said, be cool. And so there was a meeting with Jim Brown. He had no clothes on.
And he opened the door, man, and there were clothes
on. No clothes on. And there was a meeting with him as if he had clothes on.
Yeah, and he's just sitting up there talking to us.
Right.
In the nude.
With a meeting, with no clothes.
No clothes on. And daring you to look at him.
And dig, man.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. You like.
And all this madness, right? For a kid 19, I said, this is where I need to be. I just saw a manager who was negative, movie star. I met Shaft. I met Jimi Hendrix. And I see Janis Joplin at the pool. I said, I know I'm going to make it now.
My mother said I was singing before I was talking. I was raised with a bunch of ladies. I didn't know falsetto was falsetto. I just was mimicking people and singing, so it didn't register until I got up and someone came to a club and said, we have a great falsetto. Falsetto. Falsetto, that's what it is.
I didn't want to sing. When I first put the group together, I thought Philip would sing everything. I was very shy.
I just wanted to sit back and play drums and lead the band that way.
But if I hear a high voice, there was a void there, you know, so somebody had to sing the man stuff. So I had to eventually come off the drum and come out front, which I didn't want to do.
Yeah, no. Get it.
Ralph I saw playing and drums behind another group.
I had a real thing for the bass lines, because if I didn't play drums, I'd be a bass player today. I love bass guitar, you know, so that's why Dean and I have such a connection.
Ralph is sort of like my checkmate Charlie, you know? Like when we're on the stage, you know, I'll look at Ralph and say, how we're doing, because, you know, when you're on stage, there's a lot going on, you know, volume, anything may happen.
Let it be, just to make you see, he loves a ride.
And I called Larry from Denver, who was a keyboard player.
He ran to the phone and called Maurice and said, we got the guy. I think we got the guy. You know, he's real young. He doesn't have a lot of experience, but he's a good guy and he could really play. So I sat by ear and learned every song off the first two BWF albums on Warner Brothers. And when I went out, I was ready to go.
Later on, a year after that, Andrew Woolfolk, who was a saxophone player in our band.
I think I influenced the band on the jazz side and or the funk side. Those are the two areas that I kind of have my most enjoyment, playing funk music or playing the jazzy style music. And I think that was probably most of my contribution musically to Earth, Wind & Fire.
Andrew Woolfolk, give him a hand, y'all. Come on.
I was working with Isaac Hayes and went to Memphis, and I get a call saying that you know, they needed a guitar player, and I went, okay, let's check it out. And about 20 minutes later, Maurice called and we spoke, and I remembered who he was. And I went back home, went to the audition, and that was it.
My Al didn't require much of an audition coming from Sammy Davis Jr. and the Watts 103rd Street Rhythm Band. I mean, we knew who Al was, so it wasn't.
Maurice called me and asked me to come to California. When he first called me, I said, no, I'm in school right now, can't do it. But about 3 days later, I called him and said, send me a ticket.
Johnny brought kind of more of a blues influence. I brought a pop influence. And Maurice just knew how to mix them together. And it all worked.
My main contribution was the groove, to make it feel great. That's what I do more so than probably any drummer on the planet. I make it feel great. That's part of what I was born to do. I can take music and I make people move.